Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, first we will see the introduction of Boolean algebra. Earlier it was observed that the Boolean algebra was used in switching circuits and now the Boolean algebra has found its application in the designing of computers which are based on the binary numbers 0 and 1 and they correspond to off and on respectively in switching circuits. So we can say that Boolean algebra is a two-valued algebra and this Boolean algebra or the two-valued algebra was applied earlier to statements and sets which were either true or false, and now it is applied to switches which are either closed or you can say on or open, that is off. Next we discuss three basic operations in Boolean algebra. First basic operation is AND. In case of the logical statements, it is symbolized as conjunction, and in case of theory of sets, it is symbolized as intersection. Next basic operation is OR. In case of logical statements, it is symbolized as disjunction, and in case of theory of sets, it is symbolized as union. Then we have the operation NOT. In logical statements, it is symbolized as negation, and in theory of sets, it is symbolized as the complement of the set. Further, for the operation of AND, a dot would be used. For the operation of OR, plus would be used. And for the operation of NOT, a prime would be used. Now let's discuss the laws of sets the principle of duality plays an important role in the algebra of sets and the Boolean algebra. Like in set theory, union, that is denoted by this symbol, and intersection, which is denoted by this symbol, are the dual operations. That is, in a statement, if we interchange the union and the intersection, then also the new statement thus obtained would be true. And this complementation that is this symbol is a self-dual. And the universal set and the empty set are the dual elements. First, let's discuss some primary laws in this. First, we have set A, union set A is equal to set A. Then, next we have set A, intersection set A is equal to set A. These two are the idempotent laws, and by using the principle of duality we can get the second law from the first law. Then next we have A union empty set phi is equal to A. Then we have A intersection universal set xi is equal to A. Now this fourth law can be obtained from this third law using the principle of duality, since we know that the universal set and the empty set are the dual elements and union and intersection are dual operations. Next law that we have is A union the universal set xi is equal to the universal set xi. Then next we have A intersection empty set phi is equal to the empty set phi. Here also the sixth law can be obtained from the fifth law using the principle of duality. Next we discuss the associative laws . According to this associative law, we have A union B, the whole union C is equal to A union B union C, the whole. Then, next we have A intersection B, the whole intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C, the whole. Now here also, the second law can be obtained from the first law using the principle of duality, as union and intersection are the dual operations. Next, let's discuss the commutative laws. First, we have A union B is equal to B union A. Then we have A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. Here also, the second law can be obtained from the first law using the principle of duality. Next we discuss the distributive laws. In this we have A union B intersection CD whole is equal to A union B, the whole intersection A union C, the whole. Next we have A intersection B union C, the whole is equal to A intersection B, the whole union A intersection C, the whole. In this case also, the second law can be obtained from the first law using the principle of duality. Now next we have the laws of complements. In this, the first law is A union A complement is equal to the universal set Xi. Then next we have A intersection A complement is equal to the empty set Phi. Here the second law is obtained from the first law using the principle of duality. Next law is Phi complement is equal to the universal set Xi. Then we have the universal set Xi complement is equal to Phi. In this case also, this fourth law can be obtained from the third law using the principle of duality. Next law that we have is A union B, the whole complement is equal to A complement intersection B complement. Next we have A intersection B, the whole complement is equal to A complement union B complement. Now these two laws are the De Morgan's laws, and here the sixth law is obtained from the fifth law using the principle of duality. Next law that we discuss is A complement, the whole complement is equal to A. As we know that complementation is a self-dual, so this law is obtained from itself using the principle of duality. Then we have A union A intersection B, the whole is equal to A. Next is A intersection A union B, the whole is equal to A. Here this ninth law is obtained from the eighth law using the principle of duality. Next we discuss the comparison of laws of sets and arithmetic. First let's see the comparison of the commutative law in arithmetic and in laws of sets. In arithmetic, out of the four binary operations, only addition and multiplication are commutative. Like, if we have two numbers x and y, then x plus y is equal to y plus x, and x into y is equal to y into x. This is the commutative law in arithmetic, which shows that addition and multiplication are commutative. Subtraction and division do not obey the commutative law, and according to the laws of sets, the commutativity of addition and multiplication are resembled by the laws A union B is equal to B union A and A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. Next we see the comparison of the associative law in arithmetic and laws of sets. In arithmetic, again, addition and multiplication are associative, that is x plus y the whole plus z is equal to x plus y plus z the whole, where x, y and z are three numbers. Then x into y the whole into z is equal to x into y into z the whole. Now, according to the laws of sets, we have two laws which resemble these associative laws of arithmetic. So here we have A union B the whole union C is equal to A union B union C the whole. Then we have A intersection B the whole intersection C is equal to A intersection B intersection C the whole. Next law is the distributive law. We know that in arithmetic, multiplication distributes over addition. That is, we have x into y plus z the whole is equal to x into y plus x into z. And in the law of sets, we have a law which is similar to this law in arithmetic, that is A intersection B union C the whole is equal to A intersection B the whole union A intersection C the whole. But in arithmetic, addition does not distribute over multiplication, that is x plus y into z the whole is not equal to x plus y the whole into x plus z the whole. But in the law of sets, union distributes over intersection. That is, we have A union B intersection C the whole is equal to A union B the whole intersection A union B the whole. So this completes the session. Hope you have understood the introduction of Boolean algebra and the laws of sets.